Welcome to A Victim Bites Back, show 76 with Jonathan King. This episode in London, England, looking at the Duke of York Square in King's Road and various other places. A Victim Bites Back, episode 76. My opinion on the news, on films and TV, on music and all kinds of other things. A 1973 change of theme just for this week. Did you happen to see Alan Bates talking about the post office scandal all during the week? He was absolutely marvellous. In fact, he was so good, so well versed on the facts and figures, so prescient in his answers. There were a lot of yes and no's. I think we ought to make Alan Bates Prime Minister. What do you feel? But also, I found it fascinating because his approach to the post office, who he considers a total disaster area, was, and his observations of the way they behave was very, very similar to an awful lot of other organisations that I've come across. The police, the CCRC, the IOPC, that's the organisation that checks the police or fails to do so. As you know, the CCRC, which I'm having a battle with at the moment, is the Criminal Case Review Commission, who are meant to be sending back my wrongful conviction from 2001 to the Court of Appeal. 23 years we've been waiting for that to happen. But all these organisations seem to deal with things and complaints in the same way. They're very polite, they're very well mannered. They say that they do this and that, and they look at things as closely as they can. But quite often it's all fake. They're not really doing anything. And they always come to the same conclusion, sorry, we can't do anything. Funnily enough, I'm having a battle with NatWest at the moment, RBS, the Royal Bank of Scotland. Because as you may know, if you're a regular, they debanked me years before they debanked Nigel Farage. And I suspect the same person, Alison Rose, for the same reason, she didn't like the look of Farage and many people don't like the look of me, and who can blame them? But this is no reason to debank someone. And I'm getting similar, polite, spending time looking at things, coming up with answers that are not to the questions you ask, but other answers to other questions that confuse the issue without actually dealing with the facts. This is the way a lot of people work these days. And it's across society, that William Ragg, ex-conservative guy, who was doing sexting and was in the middle of that sting with lots of journalists as well as politicians and ministers getting phone calls and asking, you know, if they'd like to send photographs of their private parts and all that kind of thing. It's all madness, and it's the modern equivalent of what blackmail used to be. But with the new technology now that often uses various facilities that didn't exist in the days in the last century when you had blackmail. You don't need these days letters cut out of newspapers and such things, and money left in brown paper bags in the park. It's all done very differently. Everything now is online. And of course, we have this other major thing that we know about, because I've discussed it at length before, using the law to break the law. People are finding ways of actually doing something completely legally, which is actually committing a crime. As one gets older, and I am, of course, now 79, coming up for 80 at the end of the year, all sorts of things start going on. Physically, you start falling apart. Your joints start aching and not working properly. Most people my age have had hip replacements, which, fingers crossed, I've managed to avoid so far. But all sorts of other things. These days, I think I've told you about, when I get a cold, instead of being just like a 24-hour thing, it goes on for days, 5, 6, 7 days, a week. And it's just all these illnesses, flu, the same thing. I'm sure there are parts of COVID that are kicking in and affecting the weak parts of your body. But the other thing that I think starts happening is your mind starts going. I'm forgetting so many things these days. It's unbelievable. And one of the things I fear at my age, don't we all fear when you reach my kind of age, is Alzheimer's. Have I got early onset Alzheimer's? Is that the reason why I keep forgetting things? Not just people's names and things, but sometimes more unfortunate things, like letting something boil away on the stove, going to bed and going to sleep and coming down to find that your stove has been on all night long and has completely burnt out the pan and the food, and sometimes has started a major fire and killed you. No fun, is it? Well, all of these things need checking on. So I decided to ask my doctor what he thought. And he thought, you know what, you ought to go and see a neurologist. So he sent me off to see the top neurologist in the country, who I went to see. He was a very charming man who did various tests. And I am actually, he's recommended I go for another brain scan, if they can find the fucking thing. It's about the size of a pea these days. But a brain scan, I think it's called an MRI or something, in a few months' time, just to find out whether or not I have got early onset Alzheimer's. In which case, you'll find these rambling dissertations of a victim bites back get stranger and stranger and odder, but might be even more entertaining. So all I can suggest is keep watching them. Keep making comments on any of the ones you watch it on, be it YouTube or Reddit or Instagram or the dedicated site, www.avictimbitesback.com, or wherever it is you catch it. And do feel free to make comments, be they nice or slightly not nice. Don't be too nasty, though, or we won't put you up. Anyway, here we go. I've got to go and get tested for Alzheimer's.
From her window she climbed down in the dark, and the kisses we stole left bright red marks at the home we went touched. Those days were such alright, and Harry and the hula hoops were playing at the park that night, and the time it stood still for us alone as we swore we were never going home again. From the blue I just promised I'd be true to you, 'cause Harry and the hula hoops are playing at the harp that night. They went shine na 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 na.
Dear Dennis Corday, went to see a film called The First Omen this week. Absolutely dreadful, by the way. I loved The First Omen. And got to know Gregory Peck. We were at some strange party in California. I think it was the launch of Geffen Records at the time, which was held in Gregory Peck's house. And funnily enough, where the Bean met Cecilia Peck, Gregory's daughter, and they started dating. And she actually came and stayed with us in New York for a few days. Lovely girl. I took her to baseball games. Bean rather grudgingly came with us and became the biggest baseball fan of all time. When I was making films about 15 years ago, I met various assorted young men and tried to help them succeed in the music world.
In the midnight moonlight, I'll be walking along a lonely mile, and every time I do, I keep seeing this picture of you. Here comes the baby, here she comes now, and it comes as no surprise to me, she's with another guy. Here comes my baby, here she comes now, walking with a love that's so, so fine, never could be mine, no matter how I try. never walk alone. And you're forever talking on the phone. Well, I try to call you names, but every time it comes out the same. Here comes my baby, here she comes now. And it comes as no surprise to me, she's with another guy. Here comes my baby, here she comes now. Walking with a love that's so, so fine, and never to be mine, no matter how I try.
I'm sure that one day it's gonna start. You'll be mine to hold each day. But till then, this is all that I can say. Here comes my baby, here she comes now. And it comes as no surprise to me, she's with another guy. Oh, here comes my baby, here she comes now. Walking with a love that's so, so fine, never could be mine, no matter how I try.
Here comes my baby, here she comes now. And it comes as no surprise to me, with another guy. Here comes my baby, here she comes now. Walking with a love that's so, so fine, never to be mine, no matter how I try.
The problem was, Charlie, the one with the orange hair, really hated being a celebrity and just didn't want to go on, so I insisted that they break up, which they were all quite happy to do. But Alex continued to want to be a pop star in his own right, came up with a good song. I gave him loads of suggestions of how to break it, and indeed he did break it. It turned into a massive hit. It was, I think, Christmas in 2011, and went into the top five and sold hundreds of thousands of copies all over the world. So I was still able to assist somebody to get hit records, 15 years ago, by using the internet and various other ways of how to go about it. This is the video that Charlie made for Alex with his first huge hit.
We sing together out of key. Although we try, it seems we just can't find our harmony. We just don't fit each other's frequencies. That makes you out of reach. And I am finally accepting that about you and me. It's plain to see, we only ever wanna stay inside and watch TV, because that's just as good a memory. You're just good company. And I am finally accepting that. Remember the time when we stole the whole day? And nobody knows it, we took it away. And it will be forever mine, and it will be forever yours. Now we own the night and it can't be undone. We'll never forget how it feels to be young. Cause it will be forever mine, and it will be forever yours. Come on darling, have some indecency. You know there's nothing you can say that would embarrass me. Just our routine. We try and dream and buy the things we said we'd buy when we got more money. All in the name of making memories. That's what you want with me, and I am finally accepting that. Remember the time when we stole the whole day, and nobody knows it, we took it away. And it will be forever mine, and it will be forever yours. Now we are the night and it can't be undone. it away, and it will be forever mine, and it will be forever yours. Now we own the night, and it can't be undone. We'll never forget how it feels to be young, 'cause it will be forever mine, and it will be forever yours. This will be forever mine, this will be forever yours. Now we own the night, and it can't be undone.
You've just had the almost imponderable joy of watching Charlie Is So Cool, like, which makes you like cool.
And action!
Why is that so hard?
What makes me sad is we were all having such fun when we were young, and I was lucky enough to keep on having fun. Indeed, I'm having it now at 79 years old. All the lads in Sons of Admirals and Alex and all the rest of them, Charlie and Tommy and Ed, are all fine and happy and have happy lives now they're in their 30s. But I feel sad that the music industry has lost that marvellous, exciting, fun element it used to have. And these days, it really is dead. It's boring. It's got no mass appeal music. It's got no humour. It's got no fun. I only wish it still had that, because it was a wonderful time. Anyway, I'm still here. I'm enjoying myself. Alex is still here. He's enjoying himself. He and Georgia, his partner, girlfriend, came up, if you may remember, a few episodes ago and watched Stranger Things, the show in London, with me. We all have a great time. Life goes on. But the music industry isn't the same as it was. It was fun, even 10 years ago. I wish people then were executives who picked up on how to enjoy the music industry, not just make money from it. Anyway, who cares? See you next week for A Victim Bites Back, episode 77.